breathe in that fresh air. There's Herman, we've got some other campers here. Well, good morning everybody. It's Sunday today. Was it the 19th? I have no idea. Last night was very quiet. Did rain a bit and it's very windy. In fact, it's still windy right now. But piece-wise, it was very quiet. Now, as you can see, this is a large car park. It's actually marked out for a sign there that says coach parking. So you can imagine how big this is, if you can't tell. Now, I think what we've noticed is we do get the odd, a few cars come in, especially yesterday evening. A few cars come in, stop somewhere, or just turn around and then just leave. One of the guys here in the campers, other motorhomes, seem to think that it's the locals checking out, make sure we're not the other type of travellers, you know, the ones that don't go on holiday. But yeah, around here is quite spectacular. Last night we went to the pub, had a few cheeky pints of the black stuff, and very nice, very friendly pub. Now the pubs in, the ones we've looked into, they don't do food, which is a bit of a shame, because, you know, we'd like to pull up and have some of the local nosh. But a local beer is fine by us, I suppose. And today we are heading to Cushendun. It's just a few miles off, probably only half an hour away. And then we're moving on to Ballycastle. We're in need of some electricity. I think Herman's fine with the 12 volts, but we do need, I can't power my laptop, so I can't do any editing. And so he wants to dry hair. So we're looking for a campsite. That's our plan at the moment. When we get there, our plans obviously might change. Anyway, let's get on the road, I think. Okay, so we've arrived at Cushendun. No idea what that building is. It doesn't seem to be any signs or anything. I've gone up to the door and it's locked. But Cushendun is an NTU place, a National Trust place. It's like a little town. There's caves here as well. And apparently part of the Game of Thrones was filmed here. So I couldn't see any signs for the caves, red caves or red rock caves, but it's around the other side of where we just parked. So you cross back across the river, keep walking, and you end up finding this place. And I also found a name for that house, Glen Mona House. But like I said, it was closed, so I don't know what the use of it is. So this is the place in Game of Thrones where that woman in red, and I can't remember her name, she's like some sort of witch or something, gave birth to a hellspawn baby. Let's go deeper right into these caves and take a better look, should we?
She might still be there.
She might still be there.
Okay,
So we discovered this plaque titled The Game of Thrones, and it says the Cushendun Caves was used as a location near Storm's End in the Stormlands in season 2. And although we see this location only once, the consequences of what happened were far-reaching. Following a parley between the brothers, where Stannis Baratheon fails in his attempt to get Renly to accept him as a true king, Stannis orders Davos Seaworth to smuggle Melisandre, that's the witch I couldn't remember, ashore to a cove situated below Renly's camp. There, Davos watches in horror as the Red Princess gives birth to the shadow creature that ultimately kills Renly.
Which one was Renly then?
As the
Red Princess.
Yeah, this is, I forgot her name again. Melisandre.
Is that how you say it? Melisandre?
Yeah, something like that. Melisandre. So the caves are made up of these really strange rocks. So we've got these kind of roundish, smooth pebbles, like this one, broken, and this is a huge one. And in the middle, it's what looks like cement. And it's all over the cave,
like eggs.
Looks like an egg.
Dragon egg.
We were looking for a campsite, but didn't really fancy the ones that we went past. So we've decided to go through Ballycastle, and we found this place. This is a campsite. It's not a campsite, it's a car park. Right on the coast here at... I'm going to get the name in a second. So it's a car park at Kinbane. There's a castle and a walk, so that's where we're off to now. Check out the area. A spectacular view from up here. Midges everywhere though, that's the only problem. And that is where we're going. That just there is the remains of a castle. It's just a couple of walls now. So this is Kinbane Castle, built by McDonald's in 1547, and it's been standing here for over 500 years. Looks like it as well, doesn't it? This is just the tower. All this was the castle. You can still see some walls here, look. Thanks for watching our video. Give us a thumbs up if you enjoyed, or leave a comment. And don't forget to subscribe for more video updates, or maybe even watch one of our previous videos. Bye bye now.